Hi, my name is Nico, and this is Christina, and we're from the University of Michigan. In this video, we'll be discussing a neurological exam of sensation, as well as a little bit of motor exam as well. So the sensory exam is useful in two respects. One, as you know, pain and gross touch travel differently within the spinal cord than fine touch and vibration. So if you detect an abnormality, you can localize it within the spinal cord depending on the lesion and its findings. Second is in many neurodegenerative diseases, the disease will move from distal to proximal, and by assessing where exactly it has progressed, we can determine the severity of the disease and its progression through its course. So I'll start briefly with the progression of neurodegenerative diseases. So when you do that, so I'll have you hold out your hands. It's important to test at the most distal site you can. So if I test here at the palm and everything's normal, that is only going to be indicative of here and proximal, but I don't know how things are going distally. So I'm going to test at the fingertips. So if I had a tuning fork, I would shake it and then place it on her finger and ask if she can feel it vibrating. And then I would also use a sharp pin or something and of the sort, and then place it on another finger and ask if she feels the sharp end or the dull end. Of course, I would have to do this with her eyes closed so that she couldn't just see it. She would have to feel it. Using that, if, for example, she could feel the sharp pin on her pinky on her left hand, but she couldn't feel the tuning fork, that would help me localize where in the spinal cord the lesion was. So we talked briefly about proximal and distal sensation with regard to neurodegenerative diseases, as well as pain and fine touch. And now briefly we'll demonstrate a short motor exam. So I would have her hold her arms out like this and now push up against my hands. Okay, excellent. And so I can feel her pushing equally on both sides, so that would be a healthy or negative motor exam. And I would do that for all of the different muscles, isolating them so I could do arm flexion, forearm flexion, extension, etc. So this has been a brief overview of the sensation and motor neuro exam.